Sometimes it's a little difficult to tell what type of percentages you have when you're comparing pure water to alcohol and pure alcohol to alcohol, and the same could be said for acid in a solution. We're going to look at pure water. Pure water has 0% alcohol. And pure alcohol is 100% alcohol. In example one, it says you need a 55% alcohol solution. On hand, you have 385 milliliters of a 70% alcohol mixture. How much pure water will you need to add to obtain the desired solution? We're going to start out with a picture. Here's a beaker. And you've got 385 milliliters at 70% alcohol. And you're going to add so much more pure water to it to water it down. And that's what we need to find out. How much of that do we need for pure water? So we're going to add X amount of pure water. Here's the equation I'm going to set up. First of all, I know that I already started out with 385 milliliters. I'm going to add some amount of water to it, that's my X, and I know that when I'm all done, I'll have a total. Now I'm going to talk about the amount of alcohol. This is just talking about the amount of liquid. But now we're specifically going to break it down to how much alcohol is in the problem. We have 385 milliliters times the amount of alcohol in those milliliters, so 0.7 or 70%. We also know that we're adding water to it. We know that if it's pure water, it's 0% alcohol. And we know that we want our total to be 55% alcohol. Now I want to figure out how I can get rid of one of these variables. I've got two equations and two unknowns. So I'm going to multiply this one by negative 0.55. So when I do that, distribute that through, I get negative 211.75 minus 0.55x equals negative 0.55t. Now again, I'll write that previous problem right here down below. So when I multiply 0.7 to 385, I get 269.5. I again have 0x, and that's equal to 0.55t. When I add those together, I get 0 is equal to negative 0.55x, and when I add these together, I get 57.75. From here, I can add 0.55x to both sides. And I get 57.75 is equal to 0.55x. Now I'll divide both sides by 0.55. And I get x is equal to 105. Let's make sure that we found the right thing. We started with x as being the amount of water we needed to add to our mixture. And we needed to figure out how much water we were going to add. And down here, X is equal to 105, or 105 milliliters. Sure enough, X is the variable we needed to solve for, and it's 105 milliliters. In example 2, we see that you need a 30% alcohol solution. On hand, you have a 210 milliliter of a 10% alcohol mixture. How much pure alcohol will you need to add to obtain the desired solution? Again, we're going to draw a picture. And you're going to start out with an amount. It says that you have 210 milliliters at 10% alcohol. It also says that you're going to add pure alcohol to this mixture. So that's at 100%. And we're going to add X of it. So now we'll have more altogether. So we know that we want to end up with 30% alcohol solution. But for now, we're just going to write an equation for what we start with. We start with 210, we add X at 100% alcohol, and we get our total. Now we need to talk about the amount of alcohol. The alcohol equation is the amount times the percentage of alcohol in the amount. So the amount of alcohol in X, the pure alcohol we're adding, is 100%, so we're going to multiply it by a 1. And our total amount of alcohol when we're done is supposed to be 0.3, so we'll have T times 0.3, or 30%. So these are my two equations. Now I need to multiply my top one by something that will get rid of the variable that I don't want to keep throughout the rest of the process. I'm going to use negative 0.3 for both of these. When I do that, this is the equation I get. Distributing this through, negative 63 minus 0.3x equals negative 0.3t. 10% of 210 is 21. And 0.3 times t is just 0.3t. So here's what we're going to look at right here. Let's add them together finally. We get negative 42 plus 0.7x is equal to 0. So 42 is equal to negative 0.7x. Divide by 0.7, negative 0.7, and we get X is equal to 60. So we're going to add pure alcohol here. In my case, it's yellow alcohol. I don't know about that. And now we know how much of it we're adding. We're adding 60 milliliters to what we started with, which had 10% alcohol. So it makes sense that the amount of alcohol in the solution increases if we're pouring pure alcohol in.